Good morning, platoon. It's 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. And you know what that means. Time for Saturday morning cereals. As always, I'm your host, Captain Cartoon, bringing you the best in cartoons from the 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, and probably sooner or later in the 2000s. So, that being said, I want to thank everybody. We hit 5,000 subscribers recently. And we did a giveaway last week on Sci Fridays. I'm going to give away a prize pack this week. It's going to be random stuff. It's going to be some comic, maybe some trade paperbacks, some cartoons, stuff like that. We're going to send that out to one lucky winner today if you live in the continental United States. So, that being said, as always, Saturday morning cereals. I'm going to say Sci Fridays because I just shot that episode. Saturday morning cereals is brought to you by RU Game, the best comic book collectible, magic, toy, comic book, electronic store located at 124 North Sunset Drive, Pickle, Ohio, 45356. So, you know, this episode that I'm working on here, I think I was going to do a themed episode, and then I started putting this episode together, and this is the theme is there is no theme. This is the no rhyme or reason episode. About the only thing that might have a rhyme or reason is that I do tend to run Fantastic Voyage and Journey to the Center of the Earth side by side, and that's like the only thing I put side by side. So, so you know, you can take that for what it is. But no, there is no rhyme or reason to this episode. I can't even say I put this stuff in any order either, as it's from 60s to the 90s. So, I am going to put a couple episodes there at the end, so it maybe seem like this episode's a little short, but I'm putting two new cartoons on at the end, so hang in there, watch those. So, it's the Halloween season, it's October, check your local listings for October and Halloween's near you. You know, the captain's working on some cool stuff, but this time of the year gets me thinking about stuff and whatnot, And I talk about this a lot. Me and Joe talk about this a lot. Unfortunately, you guys have never met Joe. You've met Vince. If you've seen some of my episodes of the Group Therapy TV podcast, you've seen Brandon and Trevor. But you've never seen... Yeah, by the way, I have four kids. Four sons. All four kids. But Joe doesn't like being on the air. Me and Joe get into some really scientific stuff. We talk about parallel universes and alternate futures and alternate pasts and stuff like that. And really working on that. It's been eating at me a lot lately. It's parallel universes, man. There's something there. I've talked to, if you've checked out my other episodes of Group Therapy 2, I talked to Dr. Zombo. Super cool dude. Go check those episodes out. We get in really deep conversations about dreams and everything else like that, about how dreams are parallel universes, which they touch on in the new Doctor Strange movie. Spoiler alert, if you haven't seen that movie that came out months ago. So, yeah, but, you know, getting into the holiday season and stuff, and just, man, I get to start thinking about all that stuff, and I'm reading a lot of books on it, and a lot of articles on the internet and stuff like that, and, man, just fascinated by parallel universes. I want to hear what you guys think. Do you think there are parallel universes? Do you think there's a, you know, a universe where, you know, I always joke around is that there's a universe out there where somebody went up to George Lucas and was like, dude, don't make the prequels, you know, and he didn't make the prequels. That we only got the original trilogy and that was it. Which would be, I got a soft spot in my heart for some of the prequels, except for Phantom Menace. Still can't get around Phantom Menace. But, you know, there's all these different universes out there. Like, you know, okay, if anybody saw The Man in the High Castle, what if the Allies lost World War One or World War Two? You know, they have that one. Do you believe in parallel universes? Do you believe dreams are parallel universes? Let me know, man. Go get deep and philosophical. And on the most random episode of my show, some people tell me, you know, hey, I don't like your cartoons. I'm like, I try cartoons, man. I throw all these out. Some of them I like, some of them I just, okay, whatever. It was a shot. There's some episodes, man, that I wish I had never dared. So, take it as it is. All right, we're going to bring back a cartoon I only aired once a while back. We brought back Hot Wheels, man. And, this is the reason that they weren't allowed to show cartoons and toys were not allowed to be connected for the longest time. Because of the Hot Wheels cartoon. Remember, kids weren't smart enough to differentiate between a commercial and a 30-minute commercial for toys. I knew full well that Transformers, G.I. Joe, and He-Man was made to sell toys, but I didn't care because I liked the cartoons. One of my favorite cartoons didn't have a toy until I got much older, and that's Thundar the Barbarian. Man, how that never had a toy line back in the day was beyond me, because, man, I would have been perfect side by side with He-Man. A lot of customs out there, a lot of custom He-Man, Thundar the Barbarians. One of these days I'm going to splurge and buy one. So. All right, here you guys go. This is Hot Wheels Desert Race. Enjoy.
Hot Wheels! Hot Wheels! Hot Wheels! Hot Wheels! Keep it turning now. Keep it burning now. Keep it turning. Hot Wheels! Hot Wheels! Hot Wheels!
Again, Jack.
Right, Dad.
I think we got the blow-by problem licked.
Number 39, the Jack Wheeler team, move up.
We're getting close.
Number 171, Dexter Carter team, move up.
Did you hear what I heard? Dexter Carter? Oh, man, they don't care who they let in these races.
Well, Dexter, didn't know you were entered in this race.
Definitely entered, lads.
Where'd you get the buggy, Dex?
I had it built.
All that bread and so few brains.
We'll see, won't we? Although I don't expect this to be much of a race.
You ever drive this road before?
Not actually.
This is one of the world's toughest races. You got 100 miles of asphalt, 900 miles of rock, sand, silt, and cactus.
Yeah, they call it the biggest junkyard in the world.
You're going to see more tires blow, more drivers stranded, more cars wiped out than you've ever seen in your whole life. Be careful.
You're up 39 and 171.
Well, see you on the road, man.
Not if we can help it.
Let's go, Mickey.
Drivers, start your engines.
This is it, Mick.
Yeah.
tell me Dexter's going to play that way.
He doesn't know any other way.
Well, here goes.
Can you move over, 171?
The rules don't say I have to.
That cat never heard of manners.
No class.
Watch this.
Relax, Dexter. We can get our hands dirty. I'm going to stick in a condenser, a rotor, plugs, and coil.
Hey,
let's flip. Maybe it'll hold.
I'd say we got about 15 seconds, Coach. Boy, oh boy.
It's fixed now. Let's fire her up. I got room to pass if you'll move over.
What a dreamer.
If that Dexter won't let me pass, there's only one thing to do. I'm going to cut around him. Hey, we're ahead of him.
They're ridiculous. All I have to do is speed up and beat them.
Now we pour it on. Okay, but they sure busted up that telephone line.
Boy, oh boy, did they get creamed?
Well, with Busy Dexter out of the way, maybe we'll have a chance of winning this race. Not too far to the checkpoint now. After that, it's clear sailing.
La Paz, here we come!
Wake up, Mickey. We're at the checkpoint. Buddy, two things need to be checked out. The throttle linkage and the... What's the matter?
We got a problem. Senor Fuertes?
Oh, senor. Can you do it? Will you do it for me?
Do what?
Get her to the doctor.
Jack, his little daughter was bitten by a scorpion.
They're pretty bad down here, you know.
And he's got to get her to a doctor, and there aren't any doctors here.
Now, wait a minute. Where's the nearest medical help?
El Rosario, 100 miles. Can't one of the villagers drive her up there? No one in this town owns a car. When they need a doctor, they phone La Paz.
But the phone lines are down.
We can't even call the charter plane that brought us here.
Please.
Where's the girl?
Right here, senor. Maria.
Let's get going.
I think I better go along.
Oh, gracias, senor.
Oh, gracias, gracias.
All set?
But I can't think of a better reason to lose a race.
I pray he doesn't lose the one he's in right now, Kip.
Maria's fine. Maria is fine, but I would not have given her another hour to live without treatment. Yes, you saved her life.
Yes, you saved her life. The government expresses its gratitude to the mayor of Metro City, who has asked me to present this scroll to the Hot Wheels Car Club. And as police commissioner of Metro City, I have an award I would like to make. Jack, here.
But we weren't the winner.
You may not have won the Baja 1000, Jack, but you and the rest of the Hot Wheels won a far more important race when you chose to drive to El Rosario that night. Maria Fuertes thinks you're a winner.
I got it.
You got what?
The plans to the new M-head that Wheeler's bunch has been working on.
Okay, stupid. I'll get them back to Wheeler's Auto Shop. I don't want the plans. Let them finish building it. Then we'll just take the whole head.
Okay, that should do it. Okay, let's hook up the dynamometer and see what the special will do. I gotta do at least 120 miles an hour to win tomorrow.
That trophy sure looks good up there. I hope you and the Jackrabbit Special can keep it in the family, Jack.
That's all she's got.
Okay, cut it. We're going to need another 20 miles an hour. Why don't you kids go over for a hamburger? I want to think it out.
Come on, let's go to Mother's. Hi, Jan. Hi, Mick. The Jackrabbit came up about 20 miles short for what we'll need tomorrow. Sure wish Kip had time to test his new M-head.
I'm going to ride out to school and check with Kip.
How does Kip's new M-head work, Jack?
Well, you see, instead of a flathead, Kip has developed an M-head. Now, the shape of the head provides two explosions for better power distribution.
But due to the nature of the head's design, the center portion of the head can't be cooled adequately. And what we have then is a hot spot in the cylinder that acts much like a glow plug in a model airplane motor. The engine will just keep running even though the ignition is turned off. Your vacuum injection system wouldn't stop until the engine ran out of gas.
So, if we can chop the tail off the Jackrabbit Special by 10 pounds, we should pick up more speed.
I think we might just be able to pick up the extra 20 miles an hour, Jack.
I know what I think. I think it's terrible when a fellow never even notices what I'm wearing.
I notice, Janet. You always look beautiful. How about a dance?
I'd be delighted, Dexter.
How about celebrating with me when I win tomorrow, Janet?
You win.
So there are a lot of problems with the M-head.
Right, but now let's get started cutting some weight off the Jackrabbit's tail.
I'll have to go now, Dexter.
Spin your wheels, you guys. You don't have a chance.
Gee, it's nighttime.
Well, that's it. We've eliminated 12 pounds. Now, if the tail of the Jackrabbit holds up, we should be able to pull away.
If that M-head of Kip's were under the hood, I'd feel better.
Hello, Tank.
What's the matter?
Look, I'm at the school and I'm locked in.
Oh? How come? There wasn't any school today.
Just get your wheels and park under the auto shop window. Burn rubber. I'm lowering the M-head. Grab it. Okay, Tank, here I come. Tank, where are you? Tank, did you get the M-head?
M-head? It's up in Doc Warren's shop.
No, it isn't. I lowered it out of the window and somebody must have got it.
But you shouldn't have taken the M-head, Mick.
Why not? It's the club property.
Say,
I'll bet Dexter's demons got it. Let's get out to Dexter's place. Hey, Tank, listen to this. Dex, we're in the basement and we got it. Come through trapdoor near oil barrel.
Let's surprise him.
Here's the trapdoor, Tank. Come on, we'll catch him red-handed.
Now to install that M-head.
Uh-oh. Hey, Tank, we're in trouble.
Yeah, Mick. Let's see how much.
Oof. Oof. Oh, Tank, for the love of Mike.
You guys push my car off there now and get her tuned up for the trophy.
And Mick on it.
Steady. Now shove.
Hey, Mick, what happened?
Oh, nothing. Guess they must have moved the car.
Racers, start your engines.
If Wheeler tries to move up on you, cut him off. Now we'll see what that M-head can do for me.
Okay, push me off.
Races on the track.
Come on, Jackrabbit, move!
Kip! Dexter's got our M-head!
Is it in his car now?
Yeah!
Fool, if we don't stop him, he may have sealed his own doom.
Let's get organized. Mickey, you, Kip, Ardeth, and Janet, grab some of our message blackboards. Get the message to Dexter and Jack. Drive about 20 miles down the road. Turn around. When they get in sight, ride along the side of the road. You girls, hold up the messages and move out. We better tell the judges if Dexter can't stop, he's going to run right into that parking lot full of cars.
Dexter Carter leads. Mike Hobosh is in second place, followed by Jack Wheeler in the Jackrabbit Special.
Kip, do you think they'll be able to read the message?
Okay, Dexter, you're next.
Here they come, Mick. All right, here we go.
Dexter, stop! The M-head is dangerous. Jack! Dexter has the M-head. Help him!
Take that curve ahead to avoid those cars. I risk throwing Dexter off into a spin, so sorry, old Jackrabbit, but I'm going to have to borrow your emergency brake.
They may have named this trophy after me, but after this race, Jack, it will always be yours.
Braves stars intergalactic town.
Tex-Hex is attacking
leaving the town.
Laser fire tanks, hand shoots invisible electronic beams at the target. The bank explodes. The Brave Star strikes back and the town transforms into...
A fort? I'll blast it.
Brave Star hits the control. The wall falls. Fort Kirium, the fort that transforms into a space town with a bank, command center, and jail. New from Brave Star. Batteries not included. Toys sold separately. Assembly required.
T.O. Power takeoff. Body of steel. Soft rubber wheels. Two speeds forward. Two speeds back. Power to shift. Power to lift. P.T.O. Power takeoff. Headlight spark. Shine in the dark. P.T.O. Power takeoff. Pull yourself up if you get stuck. P.T.O.
Steel-bodied VTO, each sold separately from Buddy F.
Hey, I hope you're still liking Hot Wheels. I'm still liking. I mean, it's only a second one, and it's been forever since I showed the first one. Hot Wheels, man. Just another toy commercial. but I mean, I was a little kid, and I still knew that like I said, I still knew. Did y'all know? Y'all had to know that you know, that's what it was for, right? Right? Okay. So, we're going to keep going, and we're going to do another cartoon. I haven't aired this one before, but we're going to do one. Somebody just reminded me of this, because somebody came in the shop and asked for a book. We're doing Hardy Boys, because, to be honest, I didn't know the Hardy Boys had a cartoon until relatively recently. This is a 60s cartoon, so that explains it. I don't think I ever saw any episodes until I found these episodes. I remember watching the Hardy Boys repeats when I was a kid, because I doubt I watched them when they were first run. Probably it's in the, you know, afternoon television or something on Saturdays, I watched the Hardy Boys. But there was a Hardy Boys cartoon. No clue until relatively recently. Probably within the last month, actually. This is the Hardy Boys, and this is What Happened at Midnight. Enjoy.
407 for Bridgeport, track one.
Hey, buddy, look, you got change for a 20. I gotta catch that train.
I got a 10.
Well, so do I.
Hurry up, it's leaving.
Thanks.
Who was that?
Oh, just somebody who wanted change.
For what?
$20. Why?
Oh, no reason. Except Dad said a batch of counterfeit 20s had showed up in town. Remember?
I just remembered.
And I'll bet this is one of them. You see that discoloration?
Come on, we can still catch him.
That train ends at Bridgeport.
And it's got to slow down at the grade by Turner's Mill. Faster, Chubby! Yeah, but how? We couldn't have missed him.
Unless that's his scarf, and he jumped off before the train got here.
Oh, boy, here come the Hardys. Oh, boy, we're having a party. Life's full of mysteries, but that makes it better. So come join the Hardys, we'll solve them together. Oh, boy. Waiting for you here. When we start the action, we're sure that you'll stay near. Oh boy, here come the Hardys. Oh boy, we're having a party. Oh boy!
You were right, Joe. That discoloration proves it's not real treasury paper. Strange. The number 2 is broken each time.
Maybe they're using some new process.
Maybe.
Now what? Tomorrow's Sunday, and we promised the girls a picnic, right?
So?
So, let's have it by the mill. Maybe we'll find something.
Gee, this is really nice here.
Yeah. Say, why don't you girls get the food ready? We'll get some firewood.
Spread out! Watch for footprints! There's the start of the electron photodatagrams.
Boy, the company sure fixed the old mill up, huh?
Yeah, it makes a perfect gatehouse.
Hey, I found something. There's a cave here.
It's a good thing we brought our flashlights.
Where'd everybody go?
It's a regular tunnel.
These stones must be 300 years old. But dig these scrape marks. Someone must have been through here pretty recent.
Uh-oh, end of the line.
What's that noise?
It sounds like a wheel turning.
The mill wheel. This passage must lead under the mill. It was probably an escape route if the mill was attacked by Indians. Oh, yeah, if you're Daniel Boone. Come on, let's get back.
Wait, since when did Daniel Boone shop in a supermarket?
Well, somebody's been here all right.
Or in the mill?
That's right. Let's check with Mr. Calvin. Maybe he's seen something.
Mr. Calvin, are you there?
Yeah?
Where's Mr. Calvin?
He got transferred. What do you want?
Have you seen any suspicious strangers hanging around lately?
I ain't seen nobody. Now beat it!
Friendly, isn't he? Let's go, I'm hungry.
Here comes someone. Let's wait over there.
Come on, quick!
Thank you. It's just a delivery truck.
On Sunday?
And how come it doesn't have any business markings?
Let's hitch a ride, Frank.
I dig. You guys tell the girls. We'll be right back.
I don't get him.
Shh. Come on. Hurry up.
I keep an eye out for them snooping kids, eh? We can't take no chances, especially today.
Ah, don't worry. The warning system never fails. Get going.
That's funny. The mill wheel was stopped. And now it started again.
All right, get this unloaded.
There's something fishy about this whole operation.
I'd like to get inside this building.
Well, maybe we can. Come on. Quiet now.
Truck's leaving.
Let's move.
Blank paper. And it feels exactly like that counterfeit stuff.
Look at this new photon, Frank. I wonder if... I knew it. Look at the tube.
It's broken, just like the other.
They must have put their plates in the photon, typed out the numbers...
and used this paper for printing. That must be the new process.
There's one way to make sure.
Okay, turn it on.
All right, hold it right there. Stay where you are.
Mr. Calvin, it's us, Frank and Joe Hardy.
What are you boys doing here?
Tracking some counterfeiters.
They've been using your machines.
Are you sure?
I'm positive.
Well, I'd better call Mr. Peters. He's the head of the processing department. It's a lucky thing he's here catching up with some work today.
You say counterfeiters have been secretly using our equipment?
And somebody in your department is part of the gang. They had to have an inside man.
Well, it sounds pretty unlikely to me.
Well, we'll prove it to you. Let us run a sheet through, okay?
Well, okay, go ahead.
Man, is Dad gonna be surprised? We cracked this case.
Here it comes. Hey!
It's still blank.
Well, if that's money, it sure is counterfeit, all right. You'd better get back to your rounds, Calvin. And you kids better stop solving imaginary crimes.
That's for sure.
Boy, I guess we really blew this one.
Hey, wait a second. We forgot to remove the casings from the plates.
No wonder we...
Just a moment, please.
Uh-oh. I've got a funny feeling.
Yes. What a pity you were so observant. Well, at least we were right about an inside man.
Peters, what's up?
Nothing serious. Just get this stuff printed, fast. I'll take care of them.
Where are they?
I don't know. Come on, we better get back to that mill.
You'll never get away. They'll find us sooner or later. Perhaps, but it won't matter then, for either of us.
Hey, Peters, the wheel's stopped. Someone's coming.
I'm coming. Well, boys, it seems you get a slight reprieve. That mill wheel must be hooked into an electric eye warning system.
Let's get these ropes off.
I told you kids to get lost.
Well, you don't have to yell.
All right, we're going.
Good going. Now, how do we get out?
There's a trap door here.
And it's water. Maybe it leads into that cavern. That would explain the food wrappers.
Listen.
Come on. Watch out for the wheel. We made it. They're gone. Hurry. We must get out of here.
Hurry.
Boy, this is some picnic. If you like talking to yourself. Joe, wait!
Can't wait! I'm sorry!
Look! It's Frank and Joe!
The car! Quick! Dad, it's Joe. We're chasing the counterfeiters.
There they are!
Call the police! A green truck heading west. Highway 14 near Turner's Mill.
Uh-oh, the cops!
Well, it's about time.
Well, look who's here.
Can we have our picnic now?
Nope.
Why not?
It's gonna rain.
Oh, brother. Next time, invite us to a bank robbery. Then maybe we'll see you.
Well, we just about covered all of Shantytown.
Looks like Dad's tip about the Miami gang was wrong.
Yeah, if they're planning a robbery in Bayport, they sure aren't hiding out here.
Let's take a look.
You see anything?
What do you bums think you're doing?
Nothing.
Well, I'll give you something.
Stow it, Sutton. I don't got much soda pop left. Y'all get out of here. Don't come back.
We're going.
What'd y'all let them tramps go for?
Because they wasn't tramps. They was kids.
What kids?
Well, I got me a pretty strong notion. But we'll settle up with them later. We got more important things now.
You think he suspected?
No, but hurry. We've got to play at that masquerade party tonight.
You got your costume, Chubb?
Yeah. Gee, look at all the policemen. Do you think something happened?
No.
Hey, there's Dad. Pull up, Chubby.
Dad, what happened?
Hi, boys. The bag was held up, cleaned out.
Any clues?
Sure are. The concealed cameras got pictures of them all. They haven't got a chance.
Hey, we're going to be late. Step on it, Chubb.
See you later, Dad.
And now, the Hardy Boys.
Every day.
My nose come off the shelf. I can't control myself. I miss you so when you're away. Even when I'm sleeping, I can't keep from dreaming of the love I feel for you.
Is everybody happy?
Darn, this soda's too small.
Use mine. It's big. That's no good. They'll recognize him right away.
Very funny. Aren't you guys staying?
Uh-uh. See you tomorrow. This is it. I picked it out of the trash behind the shack.
Dr. Fizzle? I never heard of that brand.
Where's it bottled?
Miami, Florida. That's interesting.
You know it.
Well, you're up late, boys.
We were working. Did you get the photographs?
Oh, yes. Here, take a look.
Gee, they're perfect shots.
It's almost like they were posing.
It certainly is. Do you recognize any of them?
Nope.
Neither do we.
Hello?
Frank, it's Eola. Is Chubby there?
No. Try Pete's.
I did. Pete didn't come home either. My mother's afraid they were kidnapped or something.
What? Oh, that's ridiculous. They probably slept over somewhere. Go on back to bed.
What was that?
Oh, nothing. I hope.
I knew he wouldn't call. He has been kidnapped.
Why would anyone kidnap them? We'll just return these costumes. Joe, look! Those are Chubby and Pete's costumes.
Those costumes, so yes, the boys returned them first thing this morning.
Well, do you remember anything they said?
Yes, I do. They mentioned sleeping at a friend's house, and they were going fishing in Northfield this morning.
Fishing? But I...
Never mind, Frank. Thanks,
Mr. French.
Chubby wouldn't go away without telling anyone.
I agree. We better take a ride up there. Okay, Joe?
Okay.
What's the matter?
That window. There's something about it that... Listen, Iola, you stay here. I want you to do something.
Well, nothing so far.
Let's check the bait shop.
Hey! You kids are hardy boys!
We sure are. I mean, they are.
That's lucky. There's a phone call for you.
Hello? Hello, Dad? Okay, will do.
What'd he say?
He said Chubby just called home and said he was up here fishing.
I don't believe it.
Neither do I.
And that's not all. He's had a tip the bank robbers are up here.
Come on, let's look some more.
Boy, a big lot of nothing.
Wait, look over there.
Dr. Fizzle's soda.
Come on.
Muttonhead?
A mistake.
Finish them off, now!
Let's go.
Did you see them?
No, I'm afraid they really have been kidnapped.
What?
Just be cool. Did you get what I wanted?
Yes, here.
I knew it. The display's been changed. Franchi is in with the thieves. They've been using the window to transmit messages. This must mean Sutton and Dr. Fizzle are coming up by water to pick something up.
And the one this morning was to call a meeting to discuss Chubby and Pete.
No, us. That's the mistake they were talking about.
Of course. They meant to get us. But you gave Chubby your costume.
But why?
We'll tell you later when we find out.
Uh-oh. Look, that must be a warning.
Yeah, but to whom?
This window's open.
Looks like he split.
Let's try the basement.
Yow! This looks like one of my old nightmares.
Do you see anything?
No.
What's in
the... Oh, my gosh! What? Say, those look just like the bank robbers.
They are. Or rather, they're the masks they wore.
No wonder they posed for the camera. What's the matter? One of my old nightmares.
No, wait. There's someone inside there.
Chubby!
Man, that feels better.
I feel better if I know who kidnapped us and why.
It is very simple. We wanted the Hardy Boys to keep Fenton Hardy out of the case. And now we have them. Let's go! They will be here soon. Don't go away, my friends!
Well, if you're tied up now, I can come back later.
Dad!
And get those kids out fast!
Don't worry, it'll be a pleasure.
Hey, what?
I'll crown you all!
Come on out!
Hands up!
Thanks, Dad. How did you know we were there?
Well, we figured out the masks and staked out the shop. But it was you boys who made them give away their hideout.
Hey, maybe we get a reward.
You do. Part of the loot.
You mean...
Look for yourself.
Oh, brother. I should have known.
Don't pout. Check it out. Zach's gonna show you what work's about.
It's the block. It's the block.
I am the future.
What can I do?
No need to panic, no need to get scared. You can make the future by being prepared. Ask what do I like to do? What jobs are suited to me?
I like to skate. I like to go bowling. But my favorite hobby is cutting and sewing.
You can get going, plan a business sewing. It's your job, your future job.
There are many jobs you can train for. Seamstress tailor, costume designer, alterations, pattern maker.
I am the blob, the future blob.
It's no blob when you plan for a job. Don't be afraid, make a career and get paid. Do your job, plan for a future job, and you won't fear
the mean old future blob.
Rebo's got the beat, and the band plays on. You can relive it all with Kenner's Star Wars Return of the Jedi collection. Introducing Cy Snoodles and the Rebo Band. Jabba the Hutt action playset sold separately.
Play it again, Cy.
Starring Cy Snoodles, Droopy McCool on clarinet, Max Rebo on organ.
Ribbit, Rebo.
Dance, Droopy.
It's your last solo, Snoodles.
New Cy Snoodles and the Rebo Band. Jabba the Hutt action playset sold separately from Kenner's Star Wars Return of the Jedi collection.
Hey, I hope you like that. I mean, it's something different. I haven't aired it before. But somebody asked the other day, because I posted this. I did. The giant comic books. These are 100% real. They are 100% actual comics. I have Fantastic Four. I got Spider-Man. I got Marvels. I've got the Galactus-sized Fantastic Four. And the Monsters Size Monsters Unleashed, And I like these, because these are, that's, Kirby is fantastic, and this is Kirby is Mighty. And yes, it is a real book. It is a real book. See, boom. Real actual comic. They weigh probably 15 pounds a piece. They are not light. They do not fit on a bookshelf. They sit on a bookshelf, but they sit on top of the bookshelf because they don't fit in the bookshelf. So, those are real books. So, for those who asked, yes, they are real. So, we're going to keep this going. And like I said, no rhyme or reason to this episode. Don't know why. But we're bringing back... Fantastic Voyage. Man, like, yet again, a cartoon I didn't know existed. Same with Journey to the Center of Earth till recently. Cartoons I wish I would have discovered when I was a kid, man. Because I would have loved these, man. I would have definitely been on these when I was young. Because I was a fan of, like, I watched all this, you know, the Irwin Allen stuff. So this just fits right in that whole vibe, you know. This would have been like your Land of the Giants, you know, Lost in Space. Definitely been in that wheelhouse. But this is Fantastic Voyage. This is episode 5, and this is Master Spy. Enjoy.
Headquarters. CMDF, Combined Miniature Defense Force. Project
Fantastic Voyage.
Process, miniaturization. Authority, top secret, highest clearance. Team, Jonathan Kidd, commander. Guru, master of mysterious powers. Erica Lane, doctor, biologist. Busby Birdwell, scientist, inventor, builder of the Voyager. Mission? In their miniaturized form, to combat the unseen, unsuspected enemies of freedom. Time limit?
12 hours.
That's it, Dr. Glikes. The whole process.
A remarkable achievement, Professor Carter. Tell me, where is the team now?
Oh, Busby's out testing a new attack craft. The others aren't doing until later. There's no one here at all now. We're just doing some simple experiments this week. Studying water pressure, fungus molds, and salt conversion. From the inside, of course. I'm afraid you picked a bad time for your surprise visit.
On the contrary, I would say it was an excellent time.
Well, I wish I... Dr. Glikes!
The name is Seneca, Professor.
You'll never get away.
Quite right, Professor. But whoever said I wanted to get away? At least not until I finish my job. Sleep tight, dear colleague, for when you wake up, your problems will practically have disappeared. But don't worry, Professor. No one will miss you.
In fact, they won't even know you're gone.
This is Busby.
This is Kid. Come in.
That's what I want to do.
Right. Switch off power. I'll beam you in.
That's funny. I never saw that color. Hey!
What is this?
Hey! Stop! It's too fast.
Slow it down!
I can't! It's gone crazy!
Help!
no!
Busby, come in! Where are you?
Well, you might say I was up a tree.
Today's assignment will be quite simple.
That plane was supposed to be simple, too.
Accidents happen, Busby.
Unfortunately. In any event, today you stay in the lab. You will be sent into that water cylinder to test some undersea diving equipment. The depth will be 14,000 feet, after miniaturization, of course.
Great. Maybe I'll try holding my breath.
Why don't you try being quiet for a change?
This is the equipment. Mr. Kidd will try it first.
What if it doesn't work? That's pretty far down.
Then I'm afraid it'll be a long way up for Mr. Kidd.
What do you mean, Professor?
Nothing. Of course, it's just a joke.
There is one more thing. Watch the screen, please.
Isn't that Gottfried Seneca?
Yes, the most dangerous, resourceful spy the enemy has. Intelligence reports say we are his next target, so be alert.
I'd like to see him try infiltrating us. Fat chance.
Don't underestimate him. He is very clever.
Huh? Just let him try it. Ridiculous. Right, Swami?
Perhaps. But what is ridiculous to one man may be fact to another.
All set, Professor. Good. Prepare to miniaturize. Activate process.
What? Where am I?
The Voyager. I've been miniaturized. And that imposter is loose in the lab. I've got to warn them.
Wait! Wait!
Radio beam on.
Stop! Stop!
Is that something out there?
Radio beam approaching.
I must be seeing things.
Stop! Stop! He's a fake! He's trying to destroy you!
Ready to submerge, Professor. We'll take it from here.
All right, good luck.
Hold your noses!
There's the first marker, 5,000 feet.
7,500.
10,000.
12,500 feet.
14,000 feet. Take it easy, Jonathan. It's a long way up.
Yes, as Professor Carter joked, something is wrong.
What?
I don't know, yet I sense danger. Be very cautious, Mr. Kidd.
I will. Okay, let's go. That should give them enough time. Too much, in fact, for Mr. Kidd.
What did you mean, you sense danger, Guru?
He probably means he's got a toothache.
There is evil here. I feel it all around us. You must watch Mr. Kidd carefully.
Well, so far so good.
Look, over there. What are those glittery things?
I don't know, but they're heading toward Kidd.
Mr. Kidd is in danger. We must get him. Hurry.
Right. The motor's clogged.
It's some things. They're all over. That's better. But where's... Uh-oh. They've got Jonathan.
Oh, can't see. Where's the Voyager?
The squeezing cable.
Can't breathe.
Emergency. Emergency. Come in. Come in. Come in.
Sorry, Miss Lane. I can't hear you.
What is it, Carter?
I don't know, sir. Can't make it out.
And neither will Mr. Kidd.
It's no use. What'll we do, Guru?
The motor's clear. We're moving.
Thank goodness. There he is. Hurry. He's almost gone. Open the hatch.
It won't budge. Those things have jammed the gears.
I feared as much. And the pressure of the water is too great to open the other doors.
But that means... Oh, no!
Wait! There is one chance. The rockets.
You mean blast our way out?
Precisely.
Okay. Cross your fingers. what I call hanging ten.
There he is. Get us down, Bugsy. Oh, if only he's still alive.
Attention, emergency. Stand by with stretcher.
How is Mr. Kidd?
He'll pull through, sir. Just barely.
Thank goodness. I can't understand it, sir. How could those things have gotten in there?
Very simply. It was sabotage.
Sabotage?
Yes, I'm convinced of it. Someone in the organization is a traitor. Have you noticed anything unusual lately? Anything at all?
No, except Guru, of course.
What about Guru?
Oh, nothing much, but he has been acting strangely. Nervous and jumpy, always looking around. As if he were hiding something.
Guru, I wonder.
It seems impossible, but of course, he is the only foreigner in the organization.
Let's go ahead with the next experiment, but make sure you keep a close watch on Guru.
I will, sir. You have your instructions. And be careful. Prepare to miniaturize.
What's this one, Erica?
We're going inside the mold culture. It's a simple medical experiment.
No, we must not enter it. The culture has been tampered with.
Prepare for a radio beam.
We must leave at once, before the beam.
Why?
Do as I say.
Okay.
Lie alongside the container.
Yes, sir.
We're heading in.
Good luck.
You'll need it.
What is it, Guru? Why aren't we going in?
Death waits there. I feel it.
Swell. That'll look great on our report. Old Mumbo Jumbo has a funny feeling, so we couldn't carry out our mission.
Perhaps you would care to enter alone, Mr. Birdwell?
No thanks.
Why don't we drop something in and see what happens?
That's using the old noodle. Get set. Pilot to bombardier. Pilot to bombardier. Over target.
And bombs away.
What is it?
A fuel drum. Professor Carter?
No, not Professor Carter. The man who has taken his place, Gottfried Seneca.
The spy?
Yes, the spy who intends to destroy us and steal the plans for the miniaturization process.
Well, I'll be. At least we're safe for a little while. He thinks we're caught in that peanut brittle.
But where's Professor Carter?
I don't know, but it is Mr. Kidd I am worried about now.
That's right. Quick, Busby, get to the hospital.
Right!
How do you feel, Mr. Kidd?
Much better, thank you.
Good. The nurse asked me to give you this.
Thanks.
Hurry, Busby!
Well, I'd better get back. No rest for me. Don't forget the pill.
I won't. What's this one for?
Good shot, Busby. Poor Jonathan. We almost scared him to death.
Follow the imposter, Mr. Birdwell. We must discover his plans.
I've been thinking, sir. Those blueprints in the vault of the process, perhaps we should move them before Guru can get at them.
Guru? He's telling him you're the traitor.
Man, I'd like to get my hands on him. After I'm enlarged, of course.
Good idea, Carter. What do you suggest?
I'll miniaturize them and keep them myself.
Sure, he'll keep them all right.
What do we do now?
We must wait.
This is too easy. They're giving me the plans. Prepare to miniaturize.
Why don't we do something?
Patience is sometimes the most difficult of deeds. We must wait.
Activate process.
the third wave. Jump!
Bring the papers to me!
Sorry, Professor.
Professor Carter. Professor Carter.
What's that? A fire!
No, head for the alarm system. Quickly! Mr. Seneca, you cannot get out.
That's true. But then, of course, neither can you.
Attendant, bring out the attack craft. Prepare it for miniaturization.
Who'll pilot it, sir?
I will.
What's he doing?
His only chance is to destroy us.
And that's the ship to do it in, all right. Let's get moving.
You won't get away, Busby. But first, I have another call to make. He should be somewhere around there. Thank goodness, they've seen me. I thought you'd never find me. Where's... Oh, no. Not again.
Good afternoon, Professor. So nice to see you again.
What are you planning?
Just to test your new attack plane and your old one.
What happened to him?
He will return.
Then we're in trouble. That plane carries more firepower than the 6th Fleet.
But we're faster, aren't we?
Sure, in the open sky. But this is like being in a cage. And here comes our keeper. Hang on! See if you can outrun this, Busby. Magnetic comet. It'll melt us like a marshmallow.
Kid, what the blazes is going on in there? Why did Carter miniaturize?
Carter? I wonder. That's it. Quick, the sprinkler. It's going.
Look, water. Hit it, Busby.
It's too strong.
Close it.
You were lucky. But this time, you'll need more than luck. I was afraid of that. Heat-seeking missiles.
You're gaining. Do something, Jonathan.
Let's see. If I were he, I'd try the missiles next. Turn on the heating system.
It's no use. He's got us. Huh? They're turning aside.
Not doing so well, are you?
They are merely delaying their fate. I will guarantee it personally. This looks like it.
What is that?
The sodium chloride tank. See if you can make it, Busby.
We've blown the fuel tank, and here he comes.
To the left, Busby, quickly.
That's it. We're out of gas. And luck.
Maybe not. Watch.
There they are, like sitting ducks. Goodbye, my... What?
No, stop!
Thank you.
thing salt melts fast.
I'll say, when that salt rains, it really pours. Come on, let's dig him out. Here's the spy. Not so clever now, are you?
Busby. Well, I mean...
What did you do with Professor Carter?
But I am Professor Carter.
Sure you are. You better start talking.
Chain him up. He'll talk, and he'll get what's coming to him.
Wait! Is everybody crazy? I am Carter. Guru, tell them.
Hold still, you.
No, wait.
What was that?
Say, there's someone else in here.
Thank goodness. Oh, very funny, Guru.
How are you feeling, Carter?
Much better, sir.
Me too. Now that the master spy has finally met his masters.
Perhaps. But the master today may be the servant tomorrow. I fear we have not seen the last of Gottfried Seneca.
Action figures include Daisy, Boss Hog, and Cooter, each sold separately. The Dukes of Hazzard, complete with Bo, Luke, and General Lee Car by Nico.
VAK Centerfire, automatic water weapon, batteries not included, with up to 30 feet of firing power, an extra clip for reloading, a shoulder strap for moving out. There's also the M16 rifle, the sidekick pistol, the RPG rocket water launcher, the AK Centerfire.
Hey, I hope you're still liking Fantastic Voyage. I've been going through my stuff lately, and I always thought these were weird. I got a few of these. They are hardback books from Marvel. This is a few issues of X-Men. These were British annuals. And I got a couple of these. These are kind of awesome. They are hardback. This is X-Men run with Neil Adams. And, man. These were pretty cool. Really cool back in the day. So, wish we'd still get something like that. Yeah. Alright. So, we're going to keep this train of going with the journey to the center of the earth. Yet again, man. Didn't know it. Here you go. Journey Center of the Earth. This is like my only connection because I like to run these two back to back. So that's my, I guess there is a rhyme to two episodes. The rest of this is chaos. So here goes. Journey Center of the Earth, episode 4. Enjoy.
Long ago, a lone explorer named Arne Saknussemm made a fantastic descent to the fabled lost kingdom of Atlantis at the Earth's core. After many centuries, his trail was discovered. First by me, Professor Oliver Lindenbrook, my niece Cindy, student Alec McEwen, our guide Lars, and his duck Gertrude. But we were not alone. The evil Count Saknussemm, last descendant of the once noble Saknussemm family, had followed us to claim the center of the earth for his power mad schemes. He ordered his brute-like servant Tord to destroy our party. But the plan backfired, sealing the entrance forever. And so Varas began a desperate race to the Earth's core to learn the secret of the way back. This is the story of our new journey to the center of the Earth.
Safe down there.
Keep moving, everyone. I want to get off this bridge as soon as possible.
What was that?
Something's wrong with the bridge cables.
Yes. They've been cut. Get back, quickly.
Professor Lindenbrook, but this bridge is out, and so are you!
Alec! Jump, Alec! Grab on! Hurry!
Well, we almost lose you, Alec, but we get you back.
Not by much.
Back is right. We're all back, right where we started from. Only this time, there's no bridge.
Do not worry. The professor will think of something. He always does.
Well, here's what I thought of.
What is it?
It's a swamp buggy, of course.
But what makes it go? What drives it?
Can't you tell? Lars drives it.
I think next time I use keep quiet, and maybe you think of something else.
Some flowers, huh, Cindy?
I'll say. And look at those funny hanging trees.
Yeah, they're all over. Hey, aren't those vines moving?
Yes, they are. Faster, Lars. We've got to get out of here. Look out, Alec.
They're ripping the buggy apart.
Help!
Cindy! Jump!
Oh, more of them. Turn it, Lars.
Phew. I thought we were goners that time. You know, I'm not so sure this buggy was such a good idea after all.
Maybe you would rather to walk, yeah?
No, thanks.
Gee, you know, in spite of everything, this swamp sure is beautiful.
Beautiful and dangerous. What was that?
It sounds like someone in trouble. Hurry, Lars.
Not so fast, Alec. Let's see what it is first.
Look!
That poor thing. We've got to save him, Uncle Oliver.
We will, Cindy. Can you take care of the vine, Alec?
You just watch. I saved a piece of that razor-sharp coral just for something like this.
Okay, Lars. Let's go. Down, everyone!
What? What is it?
Something over there.
Professor! Professor! Look! The moss creatures!
We've got to get there before they do. Come on! Some kind of fantastic snake. Down.
What'll we do? It'll find us sooner or later.
Thank goodness for Gertrude.
That's for sure. And I used to say I wasn't afraid of snakes.
Uncle Oliver, they're taking Lars away.
Come on, we've got to get after them.
Wait, Alec. We'll never catch them on foot. They know the swamp too well. We'll take the buggy. What?
The buggy's gone.
Not a trace. That swamp man must have stolen it.
Boy, that's pretty rotten. After we saved his life.
Well, there's nothing we can do about it. We'll just have to try to follow on foot.
Through there? Won't we get lost?
I'm afraid we'll just have to take that chance.
Dog! Dog, where are you? Tog, blast you, answer me!
I am here, Kaltsaknusam.
Where?
Here.
What are you doing there? Why don't you look for the trail?
I am looking.
Where am I? This must be their home. What does he... Oh, no. This time I can fight back. In the water. They must keep prisoners under the water. I just hope this cage be waterproof. What is that? A giant octopus.
I can't keep going, Uncle Oliver. I'm too tired.
What difference does it make? We'll never catch them anyway. We're lost.
We can't give up, Alec. You know Lars wouldn't give up if you were captured.
I know. I'm not giving up. But how'll we find them, Professor? We don't even know...
Ah! There's things moving in there. I saw them.
Keep calm, Cindy. Get behind me and stay there. You too, Alec.
There's some more over there.
They're coming after us.
Get ready. Here they come.
The Swamp Man!
He came back.
And brought some of his friends with him. I just hope they're on our side. I think he means they're going to help us attack the moss creatures. He wants us to go in the canoes.
I think he wants me to go with them.
Yes. We must be going to attack from both land and water. All right. Be careful, Alec.
Right, Professor. See you later.
Let's hurry, Cindy. Lars's life may depend on how fast we get there.
There must be some way to get out of this fishbowl. Maybe that splinter. Good. Now, I will need some help from that shark, baby. Come here, Mr. Shark. Come on. That is a nice shark. Yeah, just a little closer, huh? Yeah. That is right, Mr. Shark. You've been getting good and mad, huh? You going to attack, yeah? So hard later, I promise you.
Are we almost there, do you think?
I think so. It can't be much farther if Alec and his group are coming on foot.
So that's where they hang out, huh? It looks like a big beaver dam. And there's only one guard. I'll take care of him.
Blasted Torg! You've lost the trail again. Why don't you watch where you're going?
Look, Master. Dam over water.
I see it, you fool. Why do you think I led us this way? What's that? It's Lindenbrook's young well. And he's made friends with those, whatever they are. Come on, Torg. After them. Alec! Alec, my boy! Wait for us!
Oh, no! Sack Newsome!
We're delighted to see you, my boy. We were afraid.
Shh! Be quiet!
Quiet? Nonsense! I...
Kajanok! Kajanok!
Get back! Retreat!
Happening, Torg. Stop them!
Got him! What?
Cash in that throat!
Alec and Sack Newsome! But where is Professor and Cindy?
Golly, look at it! What happens now, Uncle Oliver?
I think we'll go in through that opening, Cindy, as soon as Alec and the others get here.
But where are they? Shouldn't they have been here by now?
Yes, they should have. Unless something's gone wrong.
Look!
The entrance is being closed. Something has gone wrong.
What will they do to us?
I don't know.
I can't get you down, man.
Piranha! They're going to throw us to the piranha! Where's Lindenbrook? Why doesn't he come and save us?
He was coming in canoes, but when you warned them by making so much noise, they closed the gates. So now they can't get in.
Thank you.
Such a namashu!
Now, see here, you overgrown lichen. This has gone far enough. Roar!
Gates are opening.
Yes. Somehow we're getting a second chance. You get down, Cindy. This may be rough. Come on, hurry.
Gajajic!
It's Lars! If only he can hold them off until the professor gets inside.
Certainly did, Lars. And I think our friends here agree with you, too.
Say, what do you think happened to Count Saknussemm and Torg?
I saw them getting into one of the canoes while no one was looking.
Now that figures, leaving us to do all the dirty work while they steal a boat and escape. Boy.
Well, who knows? These canoes are pretty hard to handle. Perhaps they got what was coming to them, too.
Torg, get this canoe back into the water.
Not water, Count Saknussemm. Mud.
But, no, blast it.
Ready, Lars?
Yeah, I ready.
Okay, let's shove off.
Alec, he's got your slingshot.
I know. I'll make another. I gave him that one. And he gave me this.
Let me see that pouch. A.S. Arne Saknussemm. This pouch once belonged to Arne Saknussemm.
That means we're still on the right trail.
But how did he get it?
We'll never know that for sure, Cindy. But perhaps many years ago, Arne Saknussemm was helped on his way by their ancestors. And he too, like Alec, left them a present as a token of his gratitude.
And now watch these exciting scenes from future episodes of the all-new Journey to the Center of the Earth.
We'll be right back. Dwight Schultz, and I'll be right back with One to Grow On.
Where are you going, honey?
Oh, Jerry White and I are going to go play some ball.
Isn't he the new boy down the block?
Uh-huh.
I don't know if I like that boy, Adam.
Oh, Mom.
There's something about him that's different. Maybe you shouldn't play with him.
Hi, Adam. Hi, Mr. Stepmother.
Boy, it can be tough when your parents think differently about one of your friends than you do. But there is a way to solve the problem of choosing between dropping one of your friends and disobeying your parents. Find out what it is that your folks don't like about your friend, and at the same time, assure them that you're not so foolish as to let somebody rope you into trouble. That way they can give your friend a chance and rest easy about you.
I'll tell you what, Mom. I promise I won't get into any trouble. And Mom, if you get to know Jerry, you'll like him.
Why don't you invite him to dinner next week?
All right, Mom.
And that's One to Grow On.
What do we have here?
It's Castle Grayskull.
And it's mine.
Not so fast, Beastman. He-Man!
You can pit He-Man against Beastman playing for the power of Castle Grayskull. You have to put the castle together.
Beastman's escaping.
What's wrong, Dad? Dad, you saved the castle!
Castle Grayskull from the Masters of the Universe collection. He-Man and Beastman each sold separately from Mattel.
Hey, you know, I hope you're still liking the Fantastic Voyage and Journey. Journey to the Center of the Earth. Had to rewind that and start all over again. You know, we're talking about parallel universes and stuff like that, man. Especially with shows like Stranger Things right now. And The Upside Down, that's a great example of a parallel universe. Other dimension parallel universes. Man, it's been fascinating me a lot lately. I've been reading some books. There's some really good books on stuff like that. There's a couple, if I can remember who wrote them. One's What If the Earth Had No Moon? One of them's What If Earth Was a Moon? Cool stuff. So, you know, I'm going to keep it going. I'm going to do some laser tag. Laser tag, crazy cartoon. Still like it. Still got it. Right there, hidden behind these, is a laser tag original lunchbox. Laser Tag Academy lunchbox. If you've seen any earlier episodes, I do have laser tag guns. I play with them. But I got to get more. Because I want to get a whole bunch of people to play laser tag one of these days. So I think I'm going to start trying to buy up as many as I can again. Or if you know anybody that's got laser tag guns, let me know, man. I'm interested. So, all right. This is Laser Tag Academy. This is episode 3. And this is Yamoto's Curse. Enjoy.
1,000 years from now, a perfect world. Laser tag champion Jamie Jaron is the sole possessor of starlight power. Until the resurrection of a master criminal from the past, Draxon Dreer. Races through time in his quest to conquer the future. He is pursued by Jamie Jaron. Jamie must team with her ancestors, Tom, Beth, and Nikki Jaron. Join us now in their adventure through time to preserve the past, save the future, and keep the peace established by the Laser Tag Academy.
Welcome to Tokyo's famous gardens of Yamato. All the plants you see were developed by Dr. Yamato. They are priceless. No! Not the bonsai trees! Guards!
What are you doing, you idiots? Stop it! We've got work to do. We've got a date with Dr. Yamato.
Hello, little one. Hungry? Oh, I used a little too much.
Amazing.
I'm sorry, but no tourists allowed in here.
I want that plant food.
Sorry, it's not for sale.
Who's buying? Get it!
Okay, Beth, put one right over the plate.
Attaboy, Ralphie!
Well, that's how you play baseball. A little different than laser tag, isn't it? Come on, give it a try.
It doesn't look that difficult.
Oh, yeah? It takes years of practice to hit that ball just right. Go ahead, try it. I'll pitch.
I bet this is where she uses her magic. This time, I'm ready.
Okay, Miss Futuristic. See if you can hit this one. Nice going, Wonder Woman.
Oh, no, that's Bluto's house. He hates baseball. I'll fix it.
I got you this time! Darn, I had it! Now it's gone! You're not getting away with it! I saw you! You hit the ball through that window! And then you fixed it!
Is this your ball, kid?
Dreers in Tokyo. I'm sure he's there to get Dr. Yamato's plant food.
Plant food? What for?
To turn our world into a jungle and then conquer it.
Well, is that possible?
I'm afraid so.
Professor, don't worry. What I've learned at the Laser Tag Academy will help me stop Dreer.
And I promise to brush after every meal, too.
Let's get moving.
Hey, this thing's still wet. Why can't we go by airplane like everyone else?
Because a Godzilla pool's more fun and faster.
All right, but this time I drive.
All right, Godzilla, fire up. Whoa!
Those Germans are at it again! And me with a broken camera.
Hurry up! Collect all the plant food and don't spill any.
That was your last warning. Now, no one is the nice guy. Too bad. That was my favorite dog. I'll fix it later. You leave now or else.
Don't make me laugh.
Welcome to Japan. Now, was that a smooth ride or... Ah! How do you put this thing in reverse?
Godzilla is coming!
Sorry, guys. I must have let out the clutch too fast.
Well, at least Ralphie got something out of it. Ralphie loves sushi. Yamato's gardens are here. Hang a sharp left.
Thank you, Dr. Yamato. Your plant food is going to make it possible for me to conquer the world of 3010.
Geronimo!
Whoa! The Jarens! Get them!
That must be Dr. Yamato.
Thank you. You are on my side, I hope.
You bet, Dr. Yamato.
We must get the plant food.
No problem.
Now we can go.
This ought to take the air out of their tires.
I think we're in big trouble.
I'm afraid we are going to make big splash.
No, we won't.
Where's the plant food?
Yeah, talk about your stinking fertilizer.
The stink makes the plants grow strong.
It's all over my starlight.
Mine too. I'll just wash it off.
No, don't.
Don't what?
Poor Ralphie. I hope this stuff doesn't make hair grow.
There they are. The plant food. Get it.
I'll take care of them. My starlight's jammed. Fertilizer must be in the mechanism. Mine too.
Mine's covered with algae. It won't work.
I suggest a hasty retreat. That was a shrewd move.
Yeah, but it won't hold them for long. Let's go. Where are we going?
I suggest a fast boat to China.
Well, this is more like a slow boat to nowhere.
At least we got rid of Dreer.
Not hardly.
We don't have enough power to get away.
I got most of the algae off my starlight. I can help.
Let's make a ski jump.
He'll be back on our tail as soon as he makes a U-turn.
Where do you hide on the ocean?
An opportunity to hide is very close. Charming island, lovely plants.
Cut it out, you idiots! I know where they are! Head for that island! Full speed ahead!
What is this place?
The whole island was the Shogun's tea garden. Now it's a tourist trap. Some crazy backyard, huh?
That's nice. Now where do we hide?
Did you ever see Kabuki Theater? Kabuki is a very ancient Japanese art.
I'm sorry to interrupt, Mr. Yamato, but here comes Dreer.
Oh, yes, the bad guy. Please, follow me fast. Kabuki takes years to learn. Just try to copy the other actors.
Nothing's gonna get me up there.
Maybe you'd rather go up against Dreer with a broken starlight.
Somehow I know I'm gonna be very good at this.
Dig them out. They're here someplace.
Hot play, yes?
It's a barrel of laughs. I'm a born actor. I'm very good at this.
Yeah! the stage.
Fan out. Gotcha. Hi-ya.
You guys will eat anything.
This is a good time to end the show.
Forget the bows. They're getting away. This will grab them.
Hey, let go!
Let go!
Get their starlights and the plant food. Over here. Just as I thought, they don't work. Please don't feed the dragons. That sounds like a good rule to break.
I'll never get away with this.
I just did. Lunch is on me. Now I'm going to take over 3010.
What are those things?
Komodo dragons. They were the favorite pet of the Shogun.
They're trashing our starlights. We've got to get the starlights.
Well, maybe if you ask them nicely.
You mean like this? Jamie! Get the starlights!
These, they don't work.
Try knocking the fertilizer out of it. Hit it against something. The statue!
Please hurry. The dragons seem hungry.
Sorry, guys. Lunch is canceled. This is the fun part.
Fun's over.
Fun place, huh?
Yeah, a regular Disneyland.
That plant food must be pretty strong stuff.
Yes, and he has enough to turn world into giant vegetable garden. I'm talking 5-ton tomatoes.
Looks like we have a tossed salad in our future.
What were the creatures with Dreer?
Skugs.
This skug hair is very interesting.
This is 3010. Can't you do better than an ancient crop duster? What did you do, rob a museum? I'll use the starlight. Load that plant food. We're going to the Laser Tag Academy.
Jamie.
leaves in that pouch?
Will pruning shears do? Be careful. Shears are very sharp.
Plants are growing out of control. They're everywhere. I need your help.
Professor, our starlight.
Oh, no. They're in the computer room.
There's not enough power here to send us all. If we overload, we could get lost in time.
Lost in what? You are weird kids.
Just wait till he hears the rest of the story.
Yeah, she's from 1,000 years in the future, and she's... I think this one will work now.
How many of us will it transport?
2, I hope. Beth, you stay here with Dr. Yamato and come up with something to get rid of Dreer's plants.
Yeah, like about 1,000,000 cases of the best weed killer you can find.
Ready, Tom?
Let's do it.
That's it. The starlight's power's gone again.
Welcome to Jungle Land.
I can't believe Dr. Yamato's plant food acted this fast. How am I ever going to find the Laser Tag Academy through all this?
How about we hang a left at the next geranium?
I don't recognize anything.
Vine Street? Dreer's renaming the streets already.
Come on, the Laser Tag Academy's only 3 blocks from here.
Another 2 days on this, and Alonga will have to surrender. I'll control the world. What's this? I don't believe those Jarens. They're tough to get rid of. The Jarens are down there. I want you to take care of them permanently.
Don't you know a shortcut?
This used to be the shortcut.
1,000 years in the future, and you still use propeller airplanes.
No.
Then what was that? A bird?
No, flying skugs!
I think we better get out of here. You know who Tarzan is?
Who?
Expect. They're like monkeys.
Over there.
What's so special about... Oh, no! Academy.
We're here. We've got to find Professor Alonga. Professor!
Jamie.
Vines, they must have cut off the power to the roof.
The roof?
We're trying to use the laser star beacon against the plants.
If we can reverse the polarity with a power surge, that should kill the plants.
Jamie, get to the roof and use your starlight to power it.
You are our last hope.
Professor, contact Beth and tell her to beam into the roof of this building.
I suppose you didn't want to break their hearts by telling them our starlight's busted.
We're gonna get new ones.
We're gonna get new starlights, huh?
Where's Beth when you need her? I think it'll work now. It works! Dr. Yamato, are you ready?
The weed killer is A-OK, but I'm not too sure about this time travel.
Nikki, you stay put. Good luck! There it is!
I hope you like salads.
The Jarens!
Just when you thought it couldn't get worse, it does.
Beth, use your Starlight on the Star Beacon. The what?
Over there. Pump some power into it. Get them!
So much for that idea.
With the plants.
Squash them like bugs. Sharon, I'll be back.
You kids lead a pretty exciting life. A little too much for me.
But Dr. Yamato, how did you know your plant food would affect the Scugs?
From the hair of their chinny chin chins. Pretty smart, huh?
Come on, guys. We got to pick up Nikki and Ralphie and get back to 1987 before supper.
I sure hope we're not having salad tonight. I've seen enough green stuff for one day.
Dr. Yamato, you won't tell anybody what you saw here in the future.
I know we can trust him.
I'm real good at keeping secrets. I only talk to plants.
High-riser power cruiser. You can play with it alone or with other high-risers like the Atlas. Each sold separately. It's a complete action station with a pivoting boom and working searchlight. And six-wheel drive and independent suspension make it almost unstoppable.
It's rocking and it's rolling. Almost no place it's not going.
Two AA batteries not included. The 6x6 high-riser power cruiser and Atlas. Each sold separately. From Ideal.
Decomposed, traps liquidated. But the mighty granites, friends of the Earth Core, attack the evil humanoid, forcing him back into the Earth.
Inhumanoids! Inhumanoids!
The evil that lies within!
Your friends can't help you now!
But the leader of the granites can!
Get off!
Lead the way, the rover!
Escape from the Terror Scout!
Thanks, Granok!
Granok, other figures and vehicles sold separately from Hasbro.
Inhumanoids!
I know IDW released these recently, but, man, I was so bummed when I found out, because I was a big Transformer guy when I was a kid. I loved the comics, same with G.I. Joe, that over in England, they got a whole bunch of G.I. Joe and Transformer stuff we didn't get here in America. Also, a big Captain Britain fan. And I'm always on the lookout for Captain Britain British comics, even though I got the omnibus up there that has all of them. But, man, I get the Transformers, I get the G.I. Joe, which is Action Force, and then I get the Captain Britains. And they're magazine size, so they're not even like normal comic book size. But being, I didn't know, man. And I think I was... probably in high school, so this is well after a lot of these books had ended or were coming to an end, and being at a comic book show, and I'm like picking up a book, and it's like a magazine size, and it's like, you know, G.I. Joe, or Action Force. I'm like, the heck's Action Force? That's G.I. Joe. And then I read the first part, and it's just a regular old G.I. Joe comic. Then like I turn the page, I'm like, oh, this is new. It's a whole new story. Written by, Grant Morrison, who the hell is this guy? So, weird people worked on G.I. Joe comic books and Transformer comics overseas, man. So, alright. Hope you guys are still liking Laser Tag Academy as I go on another tirade. Rambling. Something about today. Something about, I did it last night on Sci Fridays. I just kind of rambled, and I don't know why. I apologize. Maybe it's the season. A lot going on. So we're gonna keep going in. We're gonna ignore that. We're gonna Thunderbirds 2086. People seem to be digging Thunderbirds 2086. People ask for anime. I try to bring a little bit of anime. Since I can't bring Voltron, I can't do Robotech. I see what I can do. I'm surprised I can get past Raideen. So which is literally one of my favorites. Big sucker for Raideen. If you can see, Raideen's behind me. I love my Shogun Warriors, and Raideen was one of my favorites. So I'm just love that whole thing. So here you guys go. This is Thunderbirds 2086, episode 4, Snowbound. Enjoy.
Expanding the frontiers of technical superiority into areas unknown and uncharted. Each quest promises marvelous discoveries, but each also brings potential danger. In direct response to the dangers of our advanced technology, we need an organization that is ready to mobilize dramatic survival resources at a moment's notice. Conceptions and rescue that can challenge the impossible. Thunderbirds 2086. Thunderbirds, five of the finest cadets in the world, dedicated to the service of mankind wherever he may be in distress. Combined with a dazzling array of vehicles and equipment designed to specifications in the space-age technology of the 21st century. A special rescue squad ready to answer a last-chance distress call. A call that could arrive at any time from any disaster scene on or off this planet. The Thunderbirds 2086. This is the International Rescue Command Center. Stand by for transmission from the IRO Data Cube. Avalanche alert is in effect. Monorail transports at the ski resorts are in danger of snowslides. Satellite scans now report massive storms moving into the area. All Thunderbirds stand by for action stations. Stand by for computer link and transmission of security code.
Oh boy, ski jumpers! Can I watch them too, Mommy?
Yes, but stay where I can see you.
This is Sanmaritz Monorail Central, confirming departure, Snowland.
Well, I'm glad that the monorails are on time.
Yes, and the Snowland just departed on its final run.
Well, I see that the satellite forecast predict a storm moving in later today. Have all transports brought in before that storm hits.
Welcome aboard
the Snowland, everyone. Chrissy's my name. I'll be your guide on this special tour of the great Alpine Mountains, which surround the world-famous resort of St. Moritz. 60% of Switzerland is within the Alpine Mountain chain. Skiers and vacationers come here throughout the year to enjoy the scenic beauty.
Center control, we have an avalanche at point BB1.
Huh? Control, this is the Snowland. I've got a snowslide.
I've got you on the control board. Increase speed for tunnel 40. It's 1 mile ahead.
Roger, control. Increasing the maximum speed.
It's all over.
Oh, we just made it into the tunnel.
No response, sir. The circuit into the tunnel is operating, but the induction loop isn't picking up any signals. The train went in, but hasn't come out.
Check if the video systems are operating.
Yes, sir. No good. Now the entire line in Tunnel 40 is out. The emergency generators might function.
Sir, just got an updated weather report. The storm has become more violent, and it switched direction from north to east.
It'll be coming in right on top of us.
I need help fast. I've got to get to the engineer. Please, please, try to stay calm, everybody. If you aren't hurt, help those who are. George, are you all right? George! Oh, no, he's unconscious! And the radio's blown out. I've got to get help.
Snowbirds, you are cleared for takeoff on 19 heading
099. Roger, control. Snowbirds are go. Everybody assemble over there. I'm sure the rescue squad's on the way. Just relax and stay calm. There are blankets and supplies in the maintenance tunnel. Please look at your neighbor to see if he or she is all right. Sometimes it's possible to overlook even a bad injury in the first moments after an accident.
Snowbirds, maintain proper intervals. This wind is real strong. The tunnel is directly below. Ready, all jumpers. Ready? Go! Go! Go!
Full retro! Gyro's malfunctioning!
Lower, pull up, pull up! Watch those side winds! Snow's unstable, the whole mountain could come down!
The wind's up to 135. I've got to order all my men and machines to withdraw. It's become too dangerous up here. This looks like a job for Superman. My advice is to call in the Thunderbirds.
Please stay calm, everyone. We have an emergency lighting system. The rescue team will be here any minute.
The choppers are returning. ETA, 10 minutes.
Get me into National Rescue Headquarters. I've got to talk to them. first avalanche in 50 years. A tour train is trapped in Tunnel 40 with 25 passengers and two crew. No idea how many are injured or if they've even managed to find the emergency stores. We tried to get our men and machines in, but they had to abort the mission. There are high winds and the danger of more snowslides. We need your help desperately.
You'll be needing Thunderbird 5.
Right, sir. TB2 takes freezers and TB5. TB1 goes separately.
Get moving, team. And let's be careful out there.
Roger. Roger.
Thunderbird 1 has ignition.
We gotta get out of here before the whole tunnel collapses on top of us.
What?
I think we gotta try and get out of here. Nobody's coming. They'd have been here by now.
Our only chance is to stay together in this tunnel. We'd freeze to death outside.
I say we try to find our own way out.
He's right. Let's check the wreck. Maybe we can find some tools.
You're making a mistake. The rescue squad is on its way. We should stay together.
Sure is spooky in here.
Hey, watch where you're going.
Hey, that's my foot you stepped on.
I guess we'll have to dig.
Snow looks pretty deep to me.
The girl's right. We should stay with the others.
Do what you want. I'm trying it.
Look out!
My leg's caught under these rocks.
All right. We've got you.
Hey, here we go.
Watch it. Watch it.
Hey, the coach is on fire. Where's that rescue team?
Grand standby. San Moritz Terminal is relaying site plans for Tunnel 40.
Interesting layout. They built it to last forever, and now it's sealed at both ends. Okay. We've got to get someone in to check injuries.
I think I can make it. I can drop in on a rocket pack and use my laser to dig.
The wind is too strong.
Don't worry. I've jumped into worse.
Sure, but that was in training. Okay, we're approaching target. Let's transfer Callan.
Okay, I'm ready.
The seat's all warmed up for you, Callan.
Thank you.
Thunderbird 2 will land, unload Thunderbird 5, and take off immediately. Then Thunderbird 1 will pick up the freezers and prepare for a drop. Contact the station master to have the paramedic standing by.
Thunderbird 2, this is Thunderbird 1. Prepare for link-up.
meters. All engines yield in maximum thrust. Altitude 150. Landing jacks deployed. We have touchdown.
I'm aboard Thunderbird 5. Ignite turbines. Jesse, what's the status of Thunderbird 1?
Callan's steady at 15,000. She'll start her descent in 8 seconds.
I'm taking her in, Dylan. Get ready.
All set. Rocket gyro's online.
And here we go. They're in the soup. 7,000, 6,000, 3,500. I'm right over the tunnel. Good luck, Dylan.
Here goes.
Thank you.
blasts are fierce. Going to full retros. Can't hold control. Coming in too fast. Piece of cake. No.
Good thing nobody saw that landing. I'm okay. I'm right outside Tunnel 40. Wait! I think I found a natural cave entrance. It might lead down to the tunnel. I'll see.
Be careful, Dylan.
I'm in a narrow passage. Dead end. Activating laser. Done. The rock disintegrated. That was close. I'm in the tunnel. But my charge is very low. Hold on, I'd better see what's going on in here. Gran, one of the cars is on fire. No sign of the passengers.
Douse the fire. Use the emergency phone. TB1 is now taking on the freezers.
This is the last one. Should do the job.
Take cover, I'm lifting off.
This isn't going to work. I'm going to try to find the passengers. Anybody in here?
Oh, thank goodness.
I knew the rescuers had come.
We're saved!
Where's the rest of the squad?
I'm the only one, so far.
Some of these people are injured. They have to be taken to a hospital.
Gran, I found the passengers. Get a fix on my coordinates. Some of the people need medical attention as soon as possible.
Nothing can be done yet. The freezers have to be placed first.
Okay. In the meantime, I'll give whatever first aid I can.
Callan, go in.
Roger.
Callan, what's happening up there?
As I was about to set down, the main thrusters triggered another snowslide. I'm gonna have to pull back up. Gran, I'll have to fire the bombs from altitude. It's going to be hit or miss.
Double the load. You've got to stabilize the snowmass.
Callan, use the CompuNav to set a blanket pattern, then lay the bombs down in the diffused mode. I'm going to try to handle that fire before it gets out of control. It's liable to eat up all the oxygen left in here, and very soon. Good luck, Callan. Get me all the fire extinguishers you can.
Right.
What took you so long?
That's not very funny.
Huh? I'm sorry.
Listen to me. I don't know who you are, but these people have been through a very harrowing experience. If that fire gets any worse than it is, that would end your expedition.
I said I'm sorry. My name is Dylan Beta, and I'm a captain with the International Rescue Organization, and I'm here to rescue you. Gran, this fire is out of control. You're going to have to risk entry with TB5. The place is heating up like an oven. Well, that's the last of the fire extinguishers.
Dylan, I'm in position with the freezers. Dylan!
Come in, Dylan. Gran, Dylan doesn't answer. Something's happened.
I smell gas! Patrick!
Where's that captain?
Gran, do you copy? Radio's dead. Oh, my head. I've got to get up. These people need my help.
Do you see all that gas and smoke? I think there was an explosion down there.
Don't release the freezer bombs until we know what happened in that tunnel, Callan. Just in case Dylan's helmet fails, he's equipped with a portable transmitter.
If he's been hurt, he couldn't use it.
What happened?
I found you in the main tunnel and dragged you out.
Out of there? I don't even know you.
My name is Chrissy Emerson. What did you think? That you could put out the entire fire by yourself?
I like to think positive. You know, you're not so bad at this rescue business yourself, Chrissy.
Hey, what is this? A soap opera? I want some action.
I guess it is time for me to go to work. Gran, Callan, do you read me?
Come in, Thunderbird 1.
Dylan, what's going on?
I lost you for a minute, but I'm all right now. The fire has diminished, but the fumes are still dispersing. Get us out of here.
Callan, move. Get those bombs away.
Roger. Code sequence preset and programmed. Should stabilize a snowmass.
Stay flat on the ground and try to remain as calm as possible while we try to get you out of here. Come in, Thunderbird 5. Gran, we're all set. I've frozen some blankets across the tunnel entrance to stop fumes from leaking in. We're sharing the oxygen from my emergency pack. Give me a relative position once you get rolling. And warn me, I don't want 90 tons of steel and electronics to come burrowing out over my head. Do you know your eyes are beautiful?
Gee, and I thought you never noticed my eyes. Turbo's firing. Let's go.
Ignition.
Generator, full output. Here we go. Hey, not a bad liftoff for a space cowboy. Course heading 147.
I'll never get out of here alive.
I feel sick.
All gonna die down here.
I can't.
When'll they come?
It shouldn't be much longer. Please try not to talk.
Oh, what I wouldn't do for a Galaxy Cola.
I'll get you one later.
Nearing to 192.
Oh, here, Dylan.
Oh. Half full. Hey, don't turn off the regulators. There's always more than it reads. Keep passing to the person on your left.
Watch your seismoscope readings from there on.
He could weaken the whole basaltic shelf with that tunnel, and in the substrata would give it no support.
Dylan, instruments show entry point 7. Get away from the south wall.
Stay where you are. Brace yourselves, they're coming in.
Freezer will break.
Snow slide.
Oh, Dylan.
Callan, second launch, fast.
Second freezer bomb away.
Come on, baby.
Come on, let's move. Dylan, you look as if you could use a 5-minute break.
A year in Tahiti would be more like it. But for now, I'll settle for going home.
That's a deal. Come on.
Slide. Get out, and you'd better try the north slope.
Turbo's on full. Here we come. We're out. 0.778. Tell the ski patrol to have hot chocolate ready.
How's Dylan?
Is everyone okay?
14 injuries need attention right away. Dylan's fine. Making an amazing recovery. Jesse, get word to Commander Simpson. Rescue successful. And tell him I packed our skis.
All right. See you on the slopes, Chiefy.
We'll return after these messages.
Hi there, time for Timer, your roving reporter. I'm talking to you from inside a fantastic factory, your digestive system. You know what we build here? You! Not out of wood or metal, but out of food. You see? You are what you eat, from your head down to your feet. Things like meat and eggs and fish you need to build up muscle tissue. Uh-oh! Hello, appetite control, more protein. We need energy. Playing tennis today, you know. Whoops! All these motors in your body need a lot of fuel to go on, like carbohydrates, fats, and proteins, vitamins, and so on. What's left over forms the building blocks you need, indeed, to grow on. Yes, you are what you swallow, so that next time you feel hollow, don't just fill your face with any old kind of treat. This goes for every kid or six-foot athlete. All you really are is what you eat.
Turn after these messages.
The Force is back. The rebels won't tire till they see the last of the Empire. And Kenner's there with Star Wars Return of the Jedi collection.
I'm gonna feed you to Sarlacc pit, Skywalker.
Plateau, Weequay, Luke Skywalker, and Lando Calrissian, each sold separately.
Prepare the plank, Weequay.
Surprise, surprise, I'm Lando in disguise.
Let's get out of here, Luke.
Whoa, the plank is falling.
Help!
Plateau, Weequay, Luke Skywalker, and Lando Calrissian action figures, each sold separately from Kenner's Star Wars Return of the Jedi collection.
Hope you're still liking Thunderbirds 2086, because I had some ass about that. It's Thunderbirds, it's not the puppets. No, it's not the puppets. That's Thunderbirds Go. This is Thunderbirds 2086. Totally different thing. And then somebody goes, well, this doesn't have the birds, the bird people in it that, you know, that fly through space. I'm like, no, that's Silver Hawks. Totally different than Thunderbirds. But I get it. But we're going to keep going, and we're going into Conan. Boom. Back to Conan. Man, not much I can say about Conan. Still fun. Still reading Conan to this day. I don't ever remember not reading Conan. I remember my grandpa taking me to see Conan the Barbarian. And the lady at the counter goes, you know this is rated R, right? And my grandpa looked at him and was like, my kid likes Conan. And so I got to see Conan at like 8. So way, way too early to be watching that movie. But I still love Conan. So here you guys go. This is Conan Episode 6, Men of Stone. Enjoy.
Previously on Conan the Adventurer, Conan's parents were transformed by the cruel wizard Rathamon.
I will never rest until I've restored you to flesh and blood.
Conan is aided in his quest by Needle, a magical baby phoenix.
Needle not want to go with big dumb barbarian?
Zula, who has the power to communicate with animals, and Jesmyn, a circus acrobat. Together, they fight the evil of Rathamon.
adventurer, Conan. Warrior without fear, he's more powerful than any man. His legend spreads across the land and sea.
Conan, the mightiest warrior ever. His quest, to undo the spell stone cast upon his family by driving the evil serpent men back into another dimension and vanquishing their leader, the cruel wizard Rathamon.
My spirit survives, there is hope.
Then I will crush your spirit. I will turn you to stone first.
Yes, yes, turn him to stone, turn him to stone.
The chieftain, he has been turned to stone.
Surrender now, or you will be next.
Your magic, it is too powerful.
We cannot stand against it.
Do not use your magic. Please, please.
Are you sure we can control them? They are our animal brothers. We do not control them.
But you said you would teach me.
To communicate, not to control. First, you must draw the sign of Jebel Sag. Here, let me help you. Now put your hands over the sign and repeat after me. By the sign of Jebel Sag, master of beasts, hear me, my animal brothers.
By the sign of the Jebel Sag, master of beasts, hear me, my animal brothers. Leave the waterhole now! Zula, they charge!
Conan, you cannot order the animals. They are equals. You must ask for their help.
But they charged us.
They did not charge until you presumed to order them.
Pichula! Conan! You must come quickly.
Nardu, what is it?
Rathamon! Rathamon has enslaved the entire village of Simoke!
Rathamon!
We must go at once. They must be set free.
You were brilliant, Master.
More so than you know, I used the last of my spell of stone globes on that chieftain. Windfang, I need you to get me the venom I require to create more globes. Take the dragon spawn with you.
Conan, look there!
Prince Zula, stay back! Don't come any closer!
Save yourselves!
Why do you cower so?
Crom, have you got mad? There are no Stygian guards, no snake men.
Be quiet!
Only this shrimp of a man.
Put me down, you barbarian buffoon!
He's dangerous. Do not cross him.
What's he going to do? Bite me?
I'll show you, you ignorant savage!
Crom! Oh, the sweet air.
We are restored.
And if you want to stay that way, destroy the barbarian and his friends!
But...
Do it! Unless you want to face the Medusa again!
Boom! Enough, you little!
Stop him! Stop him now!
My apologies, human thing, but I must rend you limb from limb!
You too, I'm afraid. I'll try and make it very quick!
Destroy them! Destroy them!
We must do as he says, or the Medusa will turn us back to stone!
But Medusa isn't even here! He's right. It's only the dwarf, and he's unprotected!
Get back! No! Put me down!
Let him be! The dwarf has the means to restore my parents! If you destroy him, the secret goes with him! But he is dangerous!
Treacherous!
Duplicitous!
You were turned to stone, then restored. My family was also turned to stone, but they remain in that state. They need this little man's cure. Very well. You keep the dwarf. But if he ever crosses my path again, I'll run him through.
Come, let us see how the world has changed since we last viewed it.
You saved my life.
Only so you can save my parents. Where is your magic powder?
I'm all out.
What? You lying cur. Give me the magic potion or I'll feed you to that man bull myself.
No, I'm not lying, but I can still help you.
Speak.
There's only one person who is capable of making more magic powder, the Medusa.
Then take me to him.
All right, anything you say.
How much further?
It's still a few miles away. Patience, barbarian.
Conan, the hour grows late. My tribesmen are hungry.
Ah! Needle hungry too!
You're right, Zula. Let's split up and look for food.
I'll go this way.
I'm not letting you out of my sight.
There, dragon spawn! The Temple of Medusa!
Who seeks the Medusa?
Windfang, sent by Rathamon.
Rathamon? Then you have come for the venom.
I have.
Did you bring the usual payment?
I did.
Then we may proceed. The venom is yours. I await my payment.
They are yours.
What?
We make camp here and wait for Zula and the others to return.
What's that?
Help!
Goodbye, savage beast!
The dwarf is too tough, a morsel for you. So, it is only the law of the jungle, you understand.
Conan! Do not hurt him!
Stay back, Zula! This creature is a killer!
Nonsense! Look, he's wounded! Let me handle him!
the sign of Jebel Sag, master of beasts. Hear me, my animal brother. Share with me your suffering and pain. Share with me the source of your torment.
You won't be eating my dinner anymore.
I understand. Be at peace, my animal brother.
So, what did you learn from the beast?
That he injured his claw in a trap set by the dwarf. That's why he lashed out.
The dwarf? Where is he? Krom. He's escaped. The means of restoring my parents within my grasp, but I lost it. All because of that stupid panther. Why do you continue to pamper him?
I pamper him because he is an intelligent beast, much like us. He deserves respect.
Ruins my plans, eats my food!
And he may provide the means to cure your parents.
Stop speaking in riddles. The dwarf is gone.
But you don't need the dwarf. You need the Medusa. And this panther knows all the jungle secrets. Maybe he's even seen the temple of the Medusa.
You're sure your pet knows the way to the temple?
We have been riding for hours, my prince. I mean no disrespect, but...
Conan, look there! The temple of the Medusa.
We found it! Come! Soon the cure will be mine. We need a torch.
Perhaps Needle can provide some magical means.
Needle, we need...
Needle heard! Needle have phoenix fire!
Phoenix fire? I've never heard of this before.
Stupid barbarian never asked before. Now, where do you want Needle to shine light?
In there.
In there? All right.
Needle, open your eyes. We can't go inside unless you light the way.
Too scary. Needle, no go.
Be brave.
Dumb barbarian, not understand. Phoenix memories warned me.
What?
Needle, not remember.
Conan, think Needle just scared of shadows. Now light our way.
Who seeks the Medusa?
Not Needle.
I am Conan of Sumeria.
And what do you wish?
My family has been turned to stone by the evil wizard Rathamon.
Oh, how tragic.
I beseech you, restore my family and I will give you anything, even my star metal sword.
Come closer.
Not good idea!
Needle, what is it?
Needle trying to remember!
You seek aid from the Medusa.
Now Needle, remember! Medusa evil! Do not look at Medusa's eyes!
The Medusa would never help a mortal man.
Don't look at him!
Needle!
Fritzula!
What's happening?
Most enchanting!
No, Thunder, don't look!
Oh.
has much to do and no time to do it. Zula must be avenged. What's wrong with you? Move! Lazy cat, do I have to order you to come? I warn you, cat, I've been learning of the beast world from Zula. I know the sign of the Jabal Sag. How does that chant go? Oh, yes. By the sign of the Jabal Sag, you beast, I shall be your master! What am I doing wrong?
You cannot order the animals. They are our equals. You must ask for their help.
By the sign of the Jabal Sag, master of beasts, hear me, my animal brother. I beseech you, give me your aid in avenging our friend Zula. At last, now we go. This should protect me from the Medusa's deadly gaze. Now, Panther, I need your help. I need to get to the door of the temple. Will you lead me? The doorway. Good. Now go. This is my fight. I can still smell you. Go! I said go, you stupid beast! Go! Hear me, Medusa! You have one last chance to restore my friends and family. Come forth, or I will hack those snakes from your head!
You dare challenge me? Your foolish precautions are useless. How can you strike what you cannot see? You are quick, but what if I stop speaking?
Got to tell the snakes to cease their hissing as well.
For that, you will join your friends in an eternity of living stone.
My shield.
Next, my snakes will chew through your eyelids.
Sacrifice will not be in vain, Jungle Cat. My shield.
That puny shield will not protect you now?
I think it will.
No, my gaze! Even I cannot withstand it! No! No!
Your terror is finished. And you, my noble creature, you sacrificed yourself to give me the moment I needed. What sorcery is this? The Medusa's spell is broken.
The Medusa, did I hit him?
No, but the creature is finished, my brother. Save this for another day. Poor needle. I'll miss this magical pain in the...
Ah, old barbarian calling pain!
Needle, you're alive!
Needle is Phoenix! Have many lives! Nowhere, Medusa! Did Medusa flee Needle's bravery?
Get back!
Stay your hand, barbarian! There will be no more battle this day! We owe you our lives!
Yes, now we depart in peace!
Peace! When I vanquished the Medusa, his victims were restored to flesh. Zula, do you think that means I've broken the spell that binds my parents?
It was Rathamon, not the Medusa, who put the spell on your parents. But there is an easy way to determine if Rathamon's spells were broken as well. Come,
I'm sorry, my friend, but take heart. Without the Medusa for new venom, Rathamon will be unable to turn anyone else to stone. So this day, you have had a victory.
The only victory I savor is the final victory over Rathamon. I will not rest until he has paid the price.
Quest to undo the spell of living stone cast upon his family by driving the evil serpent men back into another dimension and vanquishing their leader, the cruel wizard Rathamon.
Conan, the adventurer. Conan, man of bravery, with his magic sword protecting the mightiest of warriors.
Incredible battle chariots, the ram, the tiger, the reindeer.
Battle beasts.
And in battle transport vehicles that change into battle stations, the beetle, firebird, and shark.
Battle beasts.
And to carry your army, there's the bandolier.
Let's battle! Wood, fire, fire, beast, wood.
Battle beasts can grow into an army.
Bandolier, chariots, and transports, each sold separately.
Battle beasts.
Bandolier!
Doc Terror and Strafer attack. Max Ray calls depth charger. Energize. Torpedo. Thruster. Canopy down. Dive. The villains trap Max. Energize. Mode 2. Hydromite. Missiles. Speed thrust. Attack.
Centurion! Power Extreme!
Nano Machine!
Depth charger comes as shown. Figure sold separately. New from Kenner.
All right. Hope you're liking Conan still. I mean, I do. That's me. I'm a sucker for Conan. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, people of all ages, here we go. I want you to tell me what has changed on the set. What has changed? For a chance to win, first person to post in the comments below during when this goes live at 8 a.m. Saturday. So if you watch this later and you try to chime in a day later because there's nobody in the comments, it doesn't count. So it's got to be day of Saturday. Boom. Tell me what's changed. The books have moved around. That doesn't count. Something has changed. You tell me what it is. So that being said, I'm going to try to put some cartoons here at the end after these credits. I know this is early. It's really early. For me to end the show, but I'm going to test these couple cartoons out. Hopefully they get past YouTube. So we're going to risk it. Because if anybody's seen Fired Up, it's got to risk it to get the biscuit, whatever that means. But here we go. As always, Saturday Morning Cereals is brought to you by Are You Game? But also, remember to watch Group Therapy TV podcast every Monday at 12 noon Eastern Standard Time. Last week I dropped one with Gary Tunnicliffe. Holy crap, that guy is so much fun. I hope to have him back on the show. He's a special effects guy. He's worked on movies from Hellraiser, Feast, worked on Blade, worked on Wolverine. He's worked on Halloween movies. He's worked on about any movie you've probably seen. He's probably done some special effects for it. And he's semi-retired, so he's just letting it fly and telling you how it is. Brutally honest. So there's that, man. Just he lets you know how it is. So that was last Monday, but it's still up. Sci Fridays, every Friday at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And you're watching Saturday Morning Cereals at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. And you can find us on the Monster Channel every Friday, every Saturday and Tuesday at 10:30 a.m. Come check me out there. Old episodes. So have fun. You can check out some old episodes and see the captain before he became the captain. Before you guys decide to name me the captain. And all right, guys. I got my Patreon up and running. Any little bit helps. Helps the channel. Helps me update my equipment. Stuff like that. It's at Group Therapy TV or Patreon / Group Therapy TV. So, I know I should do this. www.patreon.com/ Group Therapy TV. Got it. So, got some cons coming up. Next Sunday, we'll be at the Jim and Dan Comic Con in Dayton at the Wright State Student Union Center. Come visit me there. The following month, I will be November 13th, the return of PickleCon. That's my show. We will have it at the Miami Valley Center Mall in Piqua from 10 to 4. A lot of good dealers coming from all over the area, artists and stuff like that, coming to hang out and sell their wares. So come check that out. And all that fun stuff. So, to quote Sturgill Simpson, why bother getting out of bed if you ain't living a dream? Yeah, remember, just because you grow older doesn't mean you have to grow up. There's always time for cartoons. And I will see you all next time. I'll see you all there. Remember, there's cartoons after these credits, so stay tuned and watch them. Hopefully there's two. Fingers crossed that I get these past you two. So enjoy, and I'll see y'all later. Bye.
Superboy and his superdog Crypto. Exciting stories of Superman when he was a boy, who as young Clark Kent devotes his superpowers to the prevention of crime and the preservation of peace for all mankind. Superboy.
On the outskirts of Smallville, Crypto, the superdog, eagerly awaits the arrival of his master, Superboy. Suddenly... Seconds later, Superboy, in his guise of Clark Kent, is seated in a classroom in Smallville High School when he is startled by a familiar, though unexpected, sound.
Jeepers, Crypto. Crypto, you know better than to come here. You want to give away my secret identity? You're trying to tell me there's trouble somewhere, huh? Then it must be a job for Superboy. Up, up, and away! Holy cow, look at that mountain. It's a mass of molten rock. Come on. We've got to dig a deep catch for that lava before it flows into the valley. That was no accident, Crypto. I wonder what or who caused it. Golly, Crypto, I'm not sure I know what you're trying to tell me.
At this very moment, some miles away, the object of Crypto's concern prepares to initiate another catastrophe. Triggered holocaust rips through the countryside. Superboy and his faithful Superdog come racing to the rescue.
Come on, Crypto. Let's break up that storm cloud. Freak occurrences, Crypto, one after another. I've got to believe someone deliberately caused them. Superdog, I've got a hunch you know who's behind this. You do? Okay, Crypto, let's go find him. Up, up, and away! Down there, Crypto. Is that the one? Come on, down! You there! Whoever or whatever you are, I want to talk to you. Wait! Great Scott! He's created a tornado! We've got to stop him before he causes any more damage. Come on! Up, up, and away! Now, friend, you've got some explaining to do. To the police. From another solar system?
Yes. Sent here to scout your world.
Incredible.
If you are a spy, just how do you figure to deliver information to your people?
Simple. By teleportation.
Teleportation?
Great Scott, Chief. Look.
Farewell, Earthlings. I shall return soon with the invasion fleet from my planet.
Did you hear that, Chief? There's no time to lose. We've got to stop that invasion before it gets started. Come on, Crypto. Up, up, and away!
Streaking up into the sky with the speed of light, Superboy and Crypto rocket through the vast void of outer space. Arriving soon at a far distant solar system.
It is they, the powerful youth and his dog, of which I told you.
Remarkable. But wait, something is wrong.
Crypto, growing weak. Something in this atmosphere draining my powers.
Strange. Somehow the dog remains unaffected. Young animal, do not move. If you do not obey, your master will be destroyed. Take him to the detention dome. Farewell, Superboy. We leave now to invade your planet Earth. We shall dispose of you immediately upon our triumphant return from Earth.
Fearing violence to Superboy, if he should attempt a rescue, Crypto can only stand by helplessly as his master makes pathetically futile attempts to break his bonds. What will happen now? On a planet in a faraway solar system where Superboy and his super dog Crypto have come to halt an impending invasion of Earth, a strange unknown element in the atmosphere has drained the boy of steel of his superpowers without affecting his super dog. And now, captured and imprisoned, he waits helpless while the would-be conquerors make ready for their journey to planet Earth.
Come on, Crypto. Find a way to get in here.
Your dog knows that if he attempts to break in to save you, you will be destroyed. Ah, the invasion fleet. It is taking off now for the invasion of Earth.
As the spaceships roar across the red sun, Superboy feels a sudden surge of returning strength. But when they have passed, he grows suddenly weak again.
That red sun, that's what's sapping my strength. Crypto, you've got to find some way to blot out the sunlight. You understand, old buddy? Find something, anything. Cover the dome. Oh, boy, go! Something to cover the dome. Something to cover the dome. Something to cover the dome. Thank you. for it, Crypto. Good dog.
Look, the Earth Boy. He grows strong again. Stop him. Destroy him.
Sorry. I've no time for games. In here, Crypto. Now to get out of this atmosphere. Right, Superdog?
With the giant pink-covered dome shielding him from the crippling rays of the red sun, Superboy and Crypto streak safely away to outer space.
I sure hope we're not too late to stop that invasion fleet, Crypto.
At this moment, the invaders' fleet is massed to strike. And in the flagship, a confident commandant plots his strategy.
Before we resort to bloodshed, we shall demonstrate to the Earthlings our capability of destroying their very means of subsistence. Commence demonstration! See how easily our giant magnifiers burn their forests.
Ha! Look! Approaching!
It is the Superboy and his dog.
But, sir, how can that be?
With a blast of his super breath, Superboy swiftly quells the blaze, but then comes another order from the flagship, and another craft leaves the formation.
Excellent. Unless Earth surrenders to us now, we shall evaporate all her waters. Superboy, battle stations! We will show this super Earthling we can tear him and his world apart! Activate anti-gravity generators, full force! How will you halt this threat, eh, Superboy?
Crypto, follow me. We can't keep this up forever, Crypto. Only thing to do is knock those spaceships out of action. Up, up, and away!
Returning to his hometown of Smallville, Superboy watches the last of the invader fleet vanish into space.
You sure taught them a good lesson, Superboy. They'll never be back to trouble this world again.
I sure hope so, Chief. But I wonder, can we really ever be sure?
When things are quiet around Smallville, there's nothing Superboy enjoys more than a workout with his super dog, Crypto. Now, as the frolicking pair romp in the sky, they are closely watched by three men hiding in the woods below.
So there they are, so now what?
The time has come to test my greatest invention, gentlemen.
What is it, Professor? A radio?
This, my friends, is a sonic beam transmitter.
So what does it do?
It transmits an ultrasonic vibration, attuned to the unique brain waves of that super dog.
I don't understand.
You will. Watch this.
What's the matter, Crypto? No, look, Crypto, I don't know what's troubling you, but playtime's over until you get over this. No, come on down. Crypto, cut it out. Knock it off, I say.
It works! It works!
It sure does, Professor.
Oh, with a mere flick of a switch, I can turn that lovable pup into an angry hound.
Yeah, so now what?
Now it's time to plot a crime wave that Smallville will never forget. Enough for now. Come on.
What's the matter, boy? What's troubling you? Okay. I know you were only clowning, Crypto. Now, come on, let's go home. Up, up, and away!
But Superboy's troubles have only begun. For the following day, as crowds jam Smallville Stadium for a sports event, armed robbers strike at the box office.
That's it. Just pass the gate receipts quietly, and no one will be harmed.
Word of the bold crime spreads swiftly, bringing Superboy and Crypto to the rescue.
Hey, look, Professor, here they come.
This will take care of them.
Crypto, stop! We've got a job to do!
That'll keep Superboy busy till we're far away!
All right, Crypto, all right, forget it. I forgive you, even if you did let the crooks escape.
Only a few hours later, as a burglar alarm brings the super pair streaking to the Smallville Museum.
Listen to this, doggy.
Oh, no, not again. Crypto, what's the matter with you? Have you lost your mind? Now quit it. Oh, Crypto, what am I going to do with you? But that's the second time you've helped criminals, Crypto. Well, let's go. There's nothing we can do around here anymore.
Resuming his secret identity of young Clark Kent, the troubled Superboy discusses his dilemma with his foster father.
What do you suppose makes Crypto act like that, Dad?
I don't know, Clark. Could be he's picked up some strange malady.
I don't think so. Because as soon as the crooks make their getaway, he snaps back to normal, begs me to forgive him, and... Wait a minute.
What is it, son?
I recall a strange ultrasonic vibration picked up by my super hearing each time Crypto turned on me. I didn't place much stock in it at the time, Dad, but I wonder.
The boy of steel hasn't long to wonder, for only a short while later, as the criminal professor and his henchmen make off with a hijacked armored car...
Don't you ever learn, Superboy?
Not this time, Crypto. All we have to do is cover your ears. Like this. There. Now you're ready for action with me, not against me. Let's go. Take that miserable toy, mister. This gadget will never bother you again, Crypto. All set, boy? Good. Next stop, Smallville Jail. Up, up, and away!
Superboy and his superdog, Krypto. Exciting stories of Superman when he was a boy, who as young Clark Kent devotes his superpowers to the prevention of crime and the preservation of peace for all mankind. Superboy.
Our crime patrol. No, Krypto. We can't play now. You know we mustn't be seen together. Now go home before someone guesses who I really am.
I've already guessed. Clark Kent, alias Superboy.
Who are you? How did you know?
My name is Klaxtor. I observed you in the tracer scope of my space saucer. But your secret identity is safe with me. For I, like you, come from the planet Krypton. Just as your father rocketed you to Earth before our world exploded, my father launched me to the planet Zaldir in another galaxy. There I, too, use my superpowers to fight evil. And now, Superboy, I have a surprise for you.
A surprise?
It will take some preparation. Meet me out at Desert Flats in 1 hour.
I can hardly wait.
Neither can I.
Okay, Claxter. What's the surprise?
That lead ball, Superboy. Pick it up and carry it off out there. That's fine. Now throw it at me.
Well, that's pure kryptonite.
Yes, kryptonite. Deadly to anyone from our world, normally. But I've overcome my weakness for kryptonite, and I can do the same for you.
You can? How?
Stand by that electronic transfuser. The scientist of Zaldir designed it. Give me your arm. Just as it transmitted their kryptonite immunity to me, it will transmit my immunity to you. Ready, Superboy?
Ready.
Finished.
You mean I'm invulnerable to kryptonite? Just like any other human?
Not so, little man. Transfuser drained you of all your superpowers. I'm not from Krypton. When you threw that lead ball at me, my chest emblem emitted a force field which shattered the ball. You once thwarted our invasion of Earth. Now you will pay for it. Agent Klaxtor reporting.
Come in, Klaxtor.
I'm ready to bring Superboy back to Zaldir for execution.
Guess again, Klaxtor. I knew you were a phony when I got a look at your hand. How could a super being have a scar like that? So, I sent an ultrasonic call to my dog. See? Using his heat vision, he burned out the master coil of your transfuser as you threw the switch. I only played along with you to find out your scheme.
You win, Superboy. But I'll still have my revenge by destroying all of Earth.
Krypto, go fetch it. Take it away. Far away.
Mm-hmm.
What?
Oh, you silly super dog. Of course we can play now. Oh, you earned it. Away!
Of Superboy and his superdog Krypto. Exciting stories of Superman when he was a boy, who as young Clark Kent devotes his superpowers to the prevention of crime and the preservation of peace for all mankind. Superboy.
Some miles off the coast, a deep sea diver prepares to descend in search of sunken treasure. His objective: an ancient wrecked galleon, lying for centuries on the ocean floor.
Suffering mackerel! Diver to ship! Diver to ship! We've just become millionaires!
Clutching his fantastic find, the diver is hoisted back to his ship, where soon an awed crew gapes in disbelief at the precious prize.
I never seen a pearl that big, Skipper.
Nor I, lass. I'll wager she fetches us a king's ransom.
She's a Neptune! What's that? Come on, Ennis!
Looks like a
dragon! Full steam ahead!
Frantic SOS fans out across the seas, reaching the coast, where the news is relayed across the land. And soon, in their general store in Smallville, young Clark Kent and his foster father hear the report by radio.
At this very moment, Coast Guard craft are speeding to the scene to investigate.
A sea dragon? Oh, it sounds crazy, Dad, but...
Does it that, Clark? Maybe you'd better look into it.
Right. This is a job for Superboy. Up, up, and away!
Racing to the rescue, the boy of steel is soon joined by another flying figure, his super dog, Krypto. Swift as lightning, Superboy and Superdog arrive at a scene of near catastrophe.
Great Krypton! That monster has the ship in two. At it, Krypto! That's it, Krypto, pull! Keep it away from the ship! Now let's get back to that dragon. Wait a minute. Am I seeing things? Look at the beast now. Playing calmly with that giant purr.
Don't tell me that's all it wanted.
Perhaps I can explain. I'm Professor Ernstus Johns.
The famous marine biologist?
Yes, Superboy. That creature is a mutation created by me. After years of experimenting and crossbreeding.
But, sir... Why would you release such a menace?
She's not a menace. She's playful, gentle. She only became enraged when that diver stole her egg.
Her egg? That pearl is an egg?
Precisely. She must have placed it in the sunken wreck for safekeeping. In the interest of science, Superboy, no harm must come to her.
Your word's good enough for me, sir. I'll make sure this never happens again. Come on, Krypto.
Down below, Superboy and Krypto tear away huge slivers from undersea rock formations. Finally, they complete an underwater corral.
Okay, Krypto, let's go up. We built her a big enclosure, Professor. She'll be safe and happy there.
With no fear of losing her precious egg. Thank you, Superboy.
Glad to be helpful, sir. Up, up, and away!
But later, as the creature is sound asleep, a small submarine glides to a stop near the enclosure. From an airlock hatch, a swimmer emerges. Now, inside the undersea craft, Shark Hawkins, notorious sea pirate, gloats over his latest prize.
What a beauty. And no one knows we've even stolen it.
Yeah, not even that little super squirt who made it so easy for us.
Pull ahead. All speed.
Presently, the creature awakens, discovers her egg is gone, and goes berserk. Once more, Superboy and his super dog respond to a radio distress signal.
That's it, Crypto. Keep her busy while I go find her egg. There's the stolen egg. After them. Gotcha. Up and away. Hang in there, Crypto. Just another second. Here's your precious egg, old girl. Seems you found a new friend, Crypto. And I've caught me a pirate to hand over to the authorities.
Days later, at a unique aquarium built near Smallville by Superboy.
Looks like everyone's happy now, Professor. You, the creature, and her baby from the hatched egg.
Yes, thanks to you, Superboy. Oh, and to you, too, Crypto.
The Adventures of Superboy and his Superdog, Crypto. Exciting stories of Superman when he was a boy, who, as young Clark Kent, devotes his superpowers to the prevention of crime and the preservation of peace for all mankind. Superboy.
This is the estate of Sad Sam Hummel, Smallville's wealthiest citizen. Wonder why he's called Sad Sam. Just watch.
Stop wasting my time. You call yourselves clowns? You couldn't make me laugh if you tickled my feet with a feather. But don't feel bad. Better men than you have tried and failed. I'm afraid no one can make me laugh except maybe... Ah, here he comes now. So you've accepted my challenge, Superboy.
How could I resist, Mr. Hummel? It's worth millions to the Smallville orphanage.
Very well. You've already heard the conditions. Just once, before my life is over, I want to know how it feels to laugh. If any man can bring me laughter, I'll bequeath my entire fortune to his favorite charity. Think you can make me laugh, Superboy?
We can sure try, sir. Ready, Crypto? Then let's get started.
What in thunder are you doing with that iron fence post?
There's nothing a super dog loves more than a super pretzel. Right, Crypto? Crypto, what are you doing? Oh, Crypto, you're too much.
Not funny.
Oh, we're just getting started.
So now what happens?
Well, now let's see. Crypto, what do you say we give this poor man another chance? Okay, but first, I gotta scuff up with some...
I'll admit you look funny, but...
Well, just a minute. I'm not finished yet. Up and away! How's that for a super bubble? Watch out, Crypto. You're getting too close to the bubble. Crypto, stay back, Crypto. Stay back, I said.
If you're all finished, You can leave now. Sorry, Superboy, but you're just not funny enough.
I'm sorry, too, Mr. Hummel. Those kids at the orphanage sure could have used that money. Anyhow, we tried our best, Crypto. Let's go. Golly, Mr. Hummel, the whole town's rooting for the orphanage. If you'd just give Superboy one more chance, maybe...
You're wasting your time, young fellow. I'm convinced there's not a soul alive who... Hey, what's wrong?
Suddenly, as a strange distant sound alerts his super hearing, the boy of steel beams his X-ray vision through the ceiling, high into the sky, where a meteorite streaks toward an unsuspecting plane.
They'll meet head-on in another few seconds.
What are you doing, young man? What costume?
This is a job for Superboy.
Up, up, and away!
That was close. Well, now my secret identity is finally out, Mr. Hummel. There was no time to slip away. You see, that meteor was so near the plane, I just didn't have time to... Mr. Hum?
You're trying to make me think that you're a Superboy? You? Meek, mild-mannered Clark Kent.
Look, Mr. Hummel.
That's the greatest joke of the century.
Yes, Mr. Hummel. That is funny, isn't it? Me, Superboy.
You're all very weak. You'd be no match.